So let's start with our revision. Today you're going to have your first revision test, okay? And the three chapters, is there any doubt from the chapter Portrait of a Lady? Yes, that's the first chapter. Do you remember what it is about? So I don't want you just to remember the summary. I want you to read all the chapters and read all the details, right? Little things that are mentioned there. Like, can anybody tell me what were the new topics that the narrator studied when he shifted to the school in the city? Yeah. Gravity. Okay, yeah, very good. Archimedes principle is one of them. So, okay, fine. That means you will be aware of the others also, right? And what subject or what information did he give when his grandmother got very upset about his school teaching? Yes? About music. So when his grandmother came to know that he was learning music. Okay. So then, of course, the other two chapters that we have were Not Afraid to Die, If We Can All Be Together, and Discovering. So these are highly technical, right? It is not that your story writing that you will do. If you have read once again the chapter, like when they set sail from Plymouth, where they started their voyage from, right? Then where did they pick up the two crewmen? Where did they pick up the two crewmen from? Yes, Cape Town, right? Yeah, South Africa. Very good. Nalin still remembers it. Okay, that means he must have read the chapter thoroughly. Good boy. Then, yeah, right. What about the nationalities? We talk about these two crewmen who are there. And Swiss, isn't it, right? So these were there. Then what happened there on like the 1st of January? So these are things there. January 1st is there, 4th is there, 5th is there. These dates are there when you what you have to remember, okay? Right? And of course, what was the makeshift anchor that they used? What had happened to the original anchor? Right? So what was the problem that happened with Sue? What did Jonathan say? Right? So what did the clouds look like? Was it really a cloud? It was a huge wave which came and lashed on the deck of the ship, and so much of damage that had happened. And then, yes, so the narrator taking a very tough decision there that what he had to do. He decided that if he wants to save himself and his family, and the boat from sinking, he had to change his destination, right? And yes, so he decided to go to the Isle of Amsterdam, right? And which is a French scientific base, and all the changes that he had to make. And yes, so in spite of limited resources, he was able to reach their proper destination. That shows that how experienced he was, how much practice he had done, and how much of thorough preparation he had done before starting on the voyage, okay? Right? So little things you have to remember, multiple choice questions. It is not about doing 1, 2, 3, 4 and your A, B, C, D or inky pinky, whatever you do, right? Please read the questions thoroughly and read the chapters also. So it's time now that you start, you know, looking at your books, finding them where they are, and actually learning and actually reading and actually studying. Discovering truth, yes, it is lots of facts that we have to remember, right? And so what was the scene there when the body was taken out of its coffin till the last when it was laid to rest, once again, under the constellation. Which constellation? Orion, right? So the goddess of afterlife, the winged goddess which had been taking care. And how old was the mummy, right? And when did Howard Carter discover? Okay, I can ask you about the sequence of events. What were the sequence of events which led to the CT scan, right? So if it's not necessary, you can say, because it's a long chronological sequence. Right, so it's a long time gap, right, from when Howard Carter discovered King Tut II when the CT scan was done. So if I had to make a timeline for it, so I've written portrait of a lady, let us do about discovering Tut also. If I had to make a timeline for that, so what were the things here? Yes, what thing would have been happened first? That, yes, the pharaoh. Yes. Need to rest. Yep. Then what would have happened? Howard Carter. Discovering it. I am writing in sequences, so it can be jumbled a sequence also. You have to arrange in sequence. Which order did these events take place? Okay? Right? So if you know it, only then you'll be able to identify it, right? Correctly. And then after that, what happened? The X-ray taken. And then later it was last was the CT scan conducted, isn't it? Right? So if this were basically, you can say the sequence of events which led to the CT scan of King Tut. So it can be in a jumbled manner. There's some more events could be also added in between. Right? Clear? So similarly, if I talk about we're not afraid to die, if we can all be together, what were the, you can say, steps taken? The life saving steps. So the life drill that was done. What did the narrator do? And he asked his team to do. So there are many things that he did, isn't it? So whether it was double lashing everything, yes, yeah, so lowering the sail, putting on the oil skins, right? And of course, getting the life rafts ready, right? All these would be the steps. But what do you have to do? You have to remember that these are the steps and in which order, which sequence, okay? Right? So if I can ask you like a statement, it could be, yeah, like different kinds of questions that you could get, right? So I have given this statement over here. The captain decided to sail to Isle Amsterdam, right? Okay. Or Isle of Amsterdam, right? Two reasons are given. Okay? Have you read them? You, Kashish, are you reading? Are you looking at the blackboard even? You can admire nails later. Fine? So I have given here, like, this is my statement. These are two reasons. Okay? You'll get a question like this, but your options could be A is correct, B is correct, third one, A is incorrect, B is correct. A is correct, B is incorrect, right? So you will get like you have your assertions and your reasoning and all. So basically we know that why did he decide to sail to Isle Amsterdam? It is reason B, isn't it? Right? So it can be asked in that way also. Clear? Right? So you can get questions like this. So B, prepared. And if you know the logic behind it, if you know that, right? So if there is a question here, you can. Yes, tell me the right one. King Tut was buried with abundant, Dipanshu, stand up, was buried with abundant funerary treasures. In fact, he has the largest or the richest funerary collection, right? The funerary treasures. So what is the reason for that? Yes, it was a belief of the Egyptians, isn't it? So once again, yeah, you have the statement, there are two reasons for it. And of course, multiple options would be given to you, but you know which is correct. So you have to identify the correct option. It is not this one. This is one question. This is the question only. The options would be along with that. Clear now? Yes. And of course, sequence also, sit down, we have done. I've done about, this also. There might be a question with two answers also, two correct answers. And so you will have to choose a correct option, right? So where is an option is there, but two answers are correct, okay? So read thoroughly. There is, once again here, no shortcut for learning. And the more you read, the more confidence you get. And I think so. I'm not here to give a lecture on morality and integrity, but I feel it's been a long time you people have appeared for any exam properly. Yes, so maybe your pre-board 2 was the last one that you gave. After that, so when you're going to have the exam this time, so I want you to be thoroughly prepared and do them honestly. Again and again, I'm emphasizing this word. Revision test, it is about your preparation. How well prepared you are or how not you are. And how much you need to work hard. Okay, so now let's come to... Yes, so let's come to speech writing. See, don't think that, yeah, it's just an objective test, so we don't have to write all these. I will be giving you writing skills. Don't worry for your practice, because at the end of the year, it is going to be a subjective test only. So then you will have to write. Then if you're going to forget how to write, your writing is going to be so bad. Maybe that's what I'm worried about, bad handwriting, okay? So forget about what you're going to write. Let's focus on your handwriting even more, okay? Right, yes. Now, speech writing. Can anybody tell me here? Do we include date, time, place in a speech? No. How do we start a speech? Do I give a title when I write a speech? Do I give a title to a speech? No, I don't give a title to the speech. It is when I am giving my introduction, when I am giving my... You can say a salutation or the greetings here. That is when I include my heading, right? Or the title. No, we don't have a title in a speech. Have you ever, you write the title, no? Because we do it out of habit. Because ma'am has given write a speech on, right? Our duty towards the environment. So we write on the top our duty towards the environment and then we write our speech after that. So we think that, okay, that is, it is a part of it. So no. We do not give a separate heading. The title is included in the introduction itself. Okay, right? And who all do you address when you start your speech? Can I get answers from you also at home? Yes, whom do we address when we start the speech? The audience, right? Yes, so naturally we start, addressing, we start showing our respect, our regards to the higher authorities who are present there, the teachers there, your friends who are there, a part of the audience. Now, when I talk about a letter writing or a speech writing, if I say, when I talk about audience, what do I mean? Audience, the people who are there right now, you are, okay, right? And it could be in the morning assembly, it could be, somewhere else, another venue in a college or in another university where this speech is happening, okay, right? Now, when I talk about the audience, that is the people who are going to listen to it, the people who are going to be influenced by it, affected by it. Who do you think what do you think has a larger audience, a letter or a speech? And give me a reason for it. Letter, why? What kind of a letter? Business letter or a formal letter? business letter. You write a complaint and you write copy to all the citizens. Is it? Yeah, so you write that. It should be to all my countrymen. Is it? No. So it is your formal letters and especially your letter to editor, right? Yeah, so when we write here, so please be very, very sure about that. Not all letters have a bigger audience. That way, you know, a speech has a much bigger audience than a letter of complaint. Okay, which you're writing to a firm or a company. There's one person who's going to read it, right? Or maybe he'll tell his members of his team also. But it is much lesser than what would be for a speech, much lesser than what for the letter to the editor. Okay, can I write my speech in the first person? Can I? Yes, or it is written in the third person? Okay, it is written in the first person. And after I have given, say, I say, Harleen, okay? Then what do I write? Is, am, are? Please remember this. Please. I am, okay? Not I is. And very confidently, we'll be standing on this public podium and we say, I, whatever, is going to. There you lose marks immediately. Okay, so please remember that. Okay, when it is a competition, you're participating, or of course, an impression that you create. Okay, right. Does the speech only contain quotations? Is it compulsory that I start my speech with a quotation? Should I end it with a quotation? A quotation is compulsory. Yeah, so it is not a compulsory part of the speech. I it's not necessary here, right? And of course here, yes. So can I add statistics in my speech? Can I add anecdotes in my speech? What are anecdotes? Very confidently say yes. What are anecdotes? Yeah, stories, right? Yeah, so make people relate to it. Okay, yes, so I can add my statistics, I can add my anecdotes, I can add my quotations also. And of course, what about questions? Yes, and does the audience respond? How confident? I just look at your confidence. No, ma'am, you can keep on talking, we're not going to give a reply. Right? And a speaker comes over there and he'll talk and talk and you'll be yawning in front of him. Please stop speaking. Isn't it? That is very bad. So yes, so if possible, please take out time and do answer the questions. What do we call those questions which we ask but don't expect a response? Rhetorics. Very good. Very good. So rhetorical questions, right? Yes. Yeah, so, and how does the inclusion of questions make the speech more interesting and interactive? Do you think the speaker asks questions to stop the audience from falling asleep? Yes. He wants the response of the listeners. He wants to gain their attention. Yeah. Or I would think, you know, like, of course, he wants to gain their attention. And how can he do that? Look at me. I'm going to ask you questions now. So to get your attention. Is it always I have to ask a question to get your attention? Then what about the content? If questions are so important, what about the content? Content is most important. Content has to be relevant. Content has to be interesting. Content has to be brief and limited, okay, right? So if I am here giving a speech on water conservation, I'm telling you, yes, that it is the need of the hour, but then I start talking about, you know, I complained to the municipal corporation, the pipes in my park are leaking and they're not coming to repair it and all. So where am I going? So you, it's a very different from the, of course, I might be giving you an example, that see, that is also the way we can save water, but I am going away, you know, like different from the topic that I am supposed to speak on. Okay, right? Yes. Now any doubts about speech writing? I just want you to be aware of what, how do I end the speech? I run away from the stage and say, okay, take care, all of you. Is it? So how is it? What you? How do I wind up this speech? A conclusion has to be there. Okay. So right. So let us write down the important elements of the speech. So I talk about my introduction, right? It could be, yeah, my quotation, it could be anything which we have discussed, right? With that, along with the greetings, and I talk about the topic. Yes, then comes, of course, the discussion of the topic. Then comes the conclusion. Conclusion is very, very important in all writing skills. So when you're writing a letter also, when you're writing a speech, all this, it is your article writing, your conclusion is very, very important. So conclusion, how does it have to be? Conclusion has to be very threatening. If you don't do this, this is going to happen. What is the purpose of the conclusion? Yes, it's a what? Highlighting the importance of the topic. Right? So conclusion is there to make you once again remember or reminder of all the points that have been discussed, right? The importance of the, what is, after all this, what is it that I'm supposed to say at the end of my speech? Yeah, I'm supposed, and thank you for being a patient listener. What is the spelling of listener? Listener, let me hear spellings. Yes, Garv, tell me the spelling of listener. Nalin, tell me. Yeah, and it is correct here. We forget an E somewhere. Between T, E. Right, you forget that, right, Gurgiras? Yes, Aditya? Right, so please, we end it with a question can be like, of course, arrange these in the sequence of writing, in the correct sequence of writing. So if you know what comes where, you can write them. Yes, can you? Yes, you can number them correctly. You can identify the sequence correctly. Okay, right. Any other doubt, any other question? Do you remember notice writing? Yes, should I discuss that also hurriedly? You know notice writing? Chapters, everything you know? Okay, give me a hornbill. Let me ask a few questions. Come on, let me see how much you know. Yes, Gurgiret, stand up. Notice is a short writing skill or a long writing skill? Okay, is there a word limit for notice writing? Sit down, make us stand up. What is the word limit for notice writing? 50, right? And plus minus, you can add 5 or 6 words, right? Okay, yes, sir. Last. Stand up, please. Do we include date in the notice? Yes. Okay. Over there. Come on, stand up. Next one. Or last over there. Yeah, that is Purav. Where do we write the time in the notice? There's no time in the notice? Okay. Yes, Dipanshu, stand up, please. What is a target group in a notice? Target group in a notice. Why do we have to think about the phone the whole day? There is more to life than just staring at your phone the whole day. What is a target group in a notice? Yes, students at home, you can also answer me. Can I get a response from you all? Yes. What is the target group in notice? Sit down, please. Sit down. Who would like to give me the answer? Because you're very confident about notice writing. What is the target? Yes, for whom the notice is meant for. So which classes, students, employees, so for whomever it is meant for. Okay, right? And where do we write the issuing authority in a notice? Where do we write the issuing authority? Which side?
Left side.
Left side. Very good. That means, yeah, no issuing authority. That is the institution, organization comes at the top. Issuing authority is the designated person who writes that. Okay. Authority. Remember authority. There. Okay. Otherwise, at the top comes the organization. Fine. Yes. Clear. Any doubts? Any questions? So we'll decide when to share the test. Okay.